Hey, Brian here. This is an interesting report because I'm going to walk you through a beta feature that is moderately helpful. I think that moderately might even be overstating it because it's really not super helpful. I think that it could be a great fit for media companies, people who have a highly engaged community. Somebody like Reddit would probably love to look at cohort reports. I think any social network as well. And actually, you know what? Anybody with an app, because what you want to do is you want to retain users. If you're Pokemon Go, you want people in there every day. If you're Twitter, you want people in there every day. And it's a really interesting thing to look at these cohorts, and determine whether or not people are coming back and when they come back. And you can, of course, use this to then activate users. So, if you know that, successful users, I hate saying the word user, but if your community, the successful group of them have to come back within the first couple of days, if that makes them more likely to become a great phenomenal user that in the future comes back every day, then you might know you need to show an ad to them. You might need to welcome them in your email and have them following on social media so that you can make sure that you get in their news feed. You might want to send an email and say we miss you. There are a lot of great activation emails and activation processes out there. If you're ever curious about it, I have some on my blog, brianswanick.com. You can always go to growthhackers.com. There's an amazing amount of resources for this. So getting into it, let's just talk about what cohorts are, or I guess who cohorts, what a cohort is. How about that? A cohort is really just a group of users. And really that's defined by some time window. In this case, it's by day. In many cases, it's by month. Sometimes you can group them into different cohorts, like people who signed up in January and signed up through Facebook or signed up through a specific campaign. Imagine we were advertising a campaign, how to fix your broken marketing program. And we had people sign up in January and then people sign up in February. They might behave differently because maybe we changed our email sequence. Maybe it was just a strange timing of events where we weren't doing as much work to earn their trust. So they might perform differently. And of course, over time, you always want your most recent cohorts to perform even better because that assumes that you're doing better marketing. In this case, we're going to look day by day because these cohorts are really grouped into all users. And again, you can always apply a segment here. I haven't actually done this on this report, so we're going to take a look and see if it works. So let's do organic traffic. And we'll see if we can apply that here. Okay, very cool. Yeah, so we're looking at organic traffic, and basically, what you're looking at here is rows of days, which are actual dates. And then this is over time. So I'll walk you through bottom to top so you can understand this for sure. So day zero for this would be September 28th, which was yesterday. So the bottom row is always yesterday. 100% of the users were active on that day. That makes sense to me. This actually doesn't make any sense to me, but we're not going to go through that. So 100% of the users were active on day zero because they came to the site on day zero. Oh, actually, you know what? This might be sessions that carry over from the previous day. Okay. So on September 28th, 100% of the users started on that day. Interesting. Day one, that is the following day. So that is September 29th. So in this case, and it is, 9 p.m., and we might actually be on Western time, so it might be earlier, it might be 6 p.m. On the following day, September 29th, 0% of people came back. It's very interesting. One, I think seeing all these low numbers means that people found the answer they were looking for and didn't necessarily think to come back. I also think that's pretty telling of all companies, just the clients that I've looked at with this report. Not a lot come back every day because if they've made a purchase, they don't have to come back. And if they're still thinking about a purchase, it might take them a couple of weeks to make it, especially high-end purchases. So unless you have a dashboard where people need to log in, SaaS products, apps, things like that, it's probably going to be pretty low. So moving up one row, we're going to look at September 27th. So September 27th, 100% of people came on that day. Yes, that makes sense. The following day, 3% of users came back, which is pretty high. That's pretty good considering there were less than 1,000. So that means that probably about a little less than 30 users came through on the following day, which is actually September 28th. On September 29th, 0% of people came back. And again, we might be looking at this really early in the day, so maybe the people aren't searching for that yet, but it's pretty interesting. So September 22nd, or 26th, and this will be the last one. And actually, I'll move right up to the top. So September 22nd, which was about a week ago, you know, we certainly see all the users coming in on that day, and we see users returning. So this is September 23rd, 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, 28th, and then 29th, and this is the 30th, which hasn't happened. So you'll notice that all of these days have this kind of like, I guess is it adjacent? I don't know. It has this line that essentially passes through all of these cells that are the same day. So this right here, this is September 29th. This one right above it is September 28th. And of course, you'll see seasonality, but week by week changes. For instance, I'm sure if we calculated which one of these was a Sunday, which I guess would be 23rd, 24th, these probably had fewer users on this day. Yeah, and you can even see this day had 558, and then 576 on this day, middle of the week, 846. So you're going to see a drop from, you know, maybe like a Thursday traffic, and you're going to see a drop around here because that means this is Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Maybe less traffic comes in there. So yeah, take that as you will. If it applies to your app, that's great. If it applies to your SaaS product, phenomenal. What you'll often see is this is used in activation even more, and hopefully Google releases a beta report for that. But for now, this is all we got. So hope that makes sense. Let me know in the questions, in the comments if you have questions. I know that's a really abstract, terrible way to explain it, but you know, I did my best. So let me know. Thanks.